Here we're going to have a look at creating up a basic reference image environment. We'll set it up so that we have two planes ready for texture maps that will be reference images. These will be of a head. They could be of any object that you have sort of blueprints or sketches or images of, and makes it nice and easy to actually model having these reference images directly in your viewport. So let's create our plane. In the front viewport, I'm just going to create a very simple one and then change it to 250 by 250 for length and width, and zoom out a little bit and rotate the view. Click on select and rotate and angle snap. We'll maximise this so we can see it's easier, and I'm going to rotate until we have 90 degrees, and we'll just have it as a copy. I want to move this so that it's just roughly on the edge. Much easier to do in the top viewport, so we'll do that now. So we've got these corners matching up. They don't have to be exact, but it's nice to have them quite close. So there's our two planes that we needed. Zoom out on the perspective view and bring these round. Right, these are ready for the texture maps, which we'll start applying now. Let's maximise the perspective viewport so that we can see exactly what's going on with the references. Let's open up the material editor and get our materials for putting the head references on. So we're going to need two slots, one for the left and one for the front. So in this first one, click on the diffuse button, select bitmap, and do our head front. And exactly the same, click on the diffuse button, bitmap, and head side. Now the head side I want to drag and put on this side, and let's show that in the viewport. And you can see this now, it's in place, ready to be used. And same for the front. Let's show that one. So you can see now we've got our left and our front images in place. They're quite dark. It's nice to be able to adjust them so that the lighting doesn't need to be changed. So what I'll do is I'll go up to the parents, and for self-illumination, just ramp this right up to 100. We'll do this for the other one, back up to the parents, self-illumination right up to 100. So now we're finished with the material editor, we don't need that anymore, and we have our reference. Now, when we're actually putting our box modelling in place, sometimes you're going to want to spin it around, and as you can see, the image planes are going to be in the way. So first of all, let's get our box in the middle so you get a rough idea of what I'm talking about. Now I can't see the box, so that's quite awkward. So what I want to do is I want to select both the planes, right click object properties, make sure you haven't selected the box, and there's few options that we need to change in this object properties dialog box. First one's freeze, and what the freeze does is that allows you to have the objects in the scene, but you can't select them, so that you can't actually select and move by accident, which sometimes happens. Next thing that we want to do is check the back face cull, and that allows us to rotate the viewport, and when the back of the reference images is shown, they go see-through. And the last setting that we need to make is show frozen in grey. So if I uncheck that one, the show frozen in grey no longer selected. So when it's frozen, the default option is to have the object grey so you can see that it's frozen, but we don't want that to happen because we won't be able to see our reference images. So I'm going to OK that, and you'll see what happens when I rotate. You can see the plane's now disappearing. Right, I'm going to select the box and right click and convert it to an editable poly, and just move this over so it's roughly in the middle of the head, and going to apply our symmetry modifier. Symmetry modifier is very useful. It allows you to model just half of an object, so rather than having to model both sides of the head for instance, I'm only going to have to model half the head. Now the mirror, depending on how you've created your objects, you have X, Y and Z, and you'll see the effect that it has with this mirror. So I need it on the X, but it's not quite in the right place. I want it on the left of the box. So if I expand this in the modifier stack and select mirror, I can actually move this across. If you find that it's not showing, you might need to select the flip, and that allows you to sort of move the mirror and have it come out the other side. Put mine set up so that it's in the right place. Let's turn on edged faces and zoom in slightly. You can see this mirror taking effect. Now the good thing is we have the weld seam selected, so when this left half of the box touches, it's actually welding and creating a solid object. So that looks about central. Now come back down to editable poly, and unfortunately the symmetry disappears, so we need to select show end result, which is this button here. We click on that one and you can see it turns all of the modifiers on in the viewport so we can see them, so it's actually showing what happens higher up. Now one other object, one other setting that you can change, it's a preference for that sometimes you might want, sometimes you might not want, is to make this box object that you're using to make your head see-through, so that you can see the reference image behind. So right click on the object, select object properties and select see-through. Okay this, and there you go, you can see your object still quite clearly, but you can also see the reference image through the middle, so you can select and move the vertices as needed.